Alright, let's get this show on the road. Hello. Hello and welcome to Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. My name is Brendan. This is the show. What's going on, guys? What is going on? Good. Lighting's all right. Okay, so I have an episode plan for today. Excuse me. Ugh. Ooh, weird. Alright. So I have an episode plan for today. Hey, Sam. I decided, since there was some when I asked last week whether or not I should continue accident whether or not I should continue Fear the Siren, a lot of people said no. We kind of figured that it was done, but in the straw poll I did include an other option, which was selected a couple times. I thought about it, and for me, the other option is actually what I want to do. Because what I decided was I want to turn Fear the Siren into a comic book script. So that's what this episode is going to be about. It's going to be about adapting Fear the Siren into a comic book format. Taking our pros and figuring out, you know, what our beats are, what things are visual, what can I show, what can I not show, things like that. That'd be interesting. I thought it'd be a little different. And it kind of gives us a proper conclusion to the Fear the Siren saga of, like, I planned a story and I wrote the pros and I didn't love it, but I came up with another way to present that story that would complete it, that would give us that sort of full closure, as it were, of this. Yeah, however you want to describe what this is. So that's my plan for today. And with that being said, whoa. Oh, there we go. That was odd. I have set up a blank project file here for our Fear the Siren comic book. Change this real quick here. Go one shot. As always, go into our metadata settings, go Fear the Siren. Oh, spell that right. We're just gonna call it Siren. So I printed out I printed out the pros that I've done so far. And I'm going to pick out some moments, some things that I think should be pages to start. So, for example, I think for me, we're going to go into story pages here. We're going to blow these guys up so you can see them. Where is, here are the options. Think. Oh yeah, so I do have this open here. I'm gonna open it up on the other side, and I'm gonna copy text across. So I'm gonna take this first paragraph here. I think that's going to be my first page. What is it? Control T, Control New. Yes. Like with when I was working on the drafting dungeon, we got to think about our page positioning. Page one is going to be when you directly open the comic, and page two is going to be, so if this is our book and we open it, cover page, page one, two, three. So I want 2-3 to be this kind of big establishing shot sort of idea. This is Paranor in the forest. This is the ruined house. Take this one. Here. So the interesting thing about doing adaptation is that there are a lot of details that come up in prose that will be totally useful towards what we're doing with the comic book script, but aren't necessarily in the right spots. For example, what you see here in cue card one is most of the first paragraph. Cue card two is the first sentence of the story, and cue card three is the next paragraph down, so the second paragraph in the story. That being said, when I'm looking at the script, and I can show you guys this, so that, well, paragraph three, I guess, is the one I use for cue card three. We get down to like paragraphs four and five, and we start seeing descriptions of what the house looks like. Those will be more useful on page 2-3 than they will be later on. So the prose has the right details, they're just not in the same order. So there's certainly that. Cross so I can see it. I think this will be probably part of this page here. So hot. Why does that? Can I lock my screen? Yes, I can. Perfect. But we're going to take this out from here. I don't have a hard page limit for this adaptation, other than it's a minimum 22 to 24 pages. I suspect it's going to be longer than that, because what we're looking at here is what? So I was thinking page 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-ish. So that's 6 pages so far, which would be a quarter of a regular issue. But we're not even into the second scene, like, there's going to be more stuff going on with that. So where are we at? So I said 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, and then I want this to be 8. Realize I was using the wrong text. old version of the first scene. So I'm gonna go fix that real quick. So part of my task, like I was saying before, is going to be reordering the details of what I had previously written. Stuff here. Where do we want to break it up? Maybe here would be good. So what are we looking at here? Looking at, let's see. Actually, I'm wrong. This should be 2 pages. always get back to. What are we gonna do? We're actually gonna do this. Organize this by scene. So we're gonna go scene one. You know what? This will probably be a double page, I would think. Yeah. Okay. And then end it. Spell. We'll go scene two. So let's open this as a double, like this, have this be here, lock that. Perfect. percentage here. How readable is the text? Is it readable? Is it not readable? If it's not, please let me know. I will fix it. But yeah. Good. I'm glad it's clear and readable. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take sentences from my prose that I think will work well for panels, or sentences and phrases really. So yeah, we're going to start with that shortcut again. I always forget this stupid shortcut. Remember, it was something like what is this open? Oh, text statistics. Okay, I got it. So apparently the forest. What do I want here? I want a panel. Okay. this will be sort of a three-panel page. My suggestion here. Not sure what the third panel would be. And this next page would be would be where our titles and credits go. So like that. Page three. Or page four, sorry. Be this guy. General text, it should be panel description, right? Here. Did I mess something up? I might have messed something up. Oh, it's because I'm copying it, that's why. Makes sense. Yep. Oh yeah, I know it should end. This page is should end with this kind of thing. Entering the house. Where? Panel one, it'll be walking. This here to get it like that. Okay. That. I realize that this line here will probably not be on this page. So yeah. Okay. Describe the house here in more detail. So what page would we be on? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. Okay. Oh, I know what I should do. Yeah, what I should do is I should take these panels here and I should put them here. That or don't actually delete that. Put that back. What we want is we want this here. Okay. This. If you're not following my thought process, please don't hesitate to ask questions and stop me. I'm kind of just doing my own thing. this real quick. So, makes sense. So it'll be three panels at least. So copy those in. It'll be like this. Make sure my pages make sense. So, page one. You know what I should do? In order to make this easier, I'm gonna go like this. To be like movement, or I flip page. Two, 3, 4, 5. Kitchen. Oh, I need to have him search. That's what I'm missing here. problem right now is that I want the kitchen maybe the kitchen should be a 2-page spread. Maybe that would fix it. Because I want the surprise attack to be on an even numbered page, and I want the siren to be on an odd numbered page. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Because odds are right and evens are left. So 7, 8, 9, 10. So kitchen's good as a 6. That and back outside would be 7, surprise attack would be 8, siren would be 9. Oh yeah, it'll definitely be a full page. I just meant that it would make more sense to be, you want it on the right side, but it would be a full page. There you are. My comic book drafting notebook. So I can work through some stuff. Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to go for. Just gonna do a couple of quick sketches here, see if I can figure out what my pacing weirdness is right now. courtyard. So he looks in, sees nothing, goes inside. So this would be the house. That makes sense. He walks in. We get some other detail about the house. Enters the doorway. Hey, Johnny.
Going on.
So six should be the kitchen. I want the kitchen to be kind of like him standing. There's like all this crazy stuff happening in the background, sort of thing. We are. Though I'm doing something a little different today. I'm actually I decided that I didn't want to drop the story because I really like it, but I didn't want to keep working on drafts of the prose. So I figured what I would do is I would adapt it to be a comic book. Just like a one-shot, single-issue sort of comic book version of the story. For a couple reasons. One, well, the first one being the one I already said, because I don't want to drop the story. Two, because I wanted to actually kind of talk about adaptation and talk about moving something from one format to another. I've touched on that before where I talked about the idea of where like where stories fit. Like, do are they a visual story? Are they an internal story? What works and what doesn't? So yeah, there's a lot of that. And three, I just kind of felt like doing a comic book. Yeah, probably. It's probably just me today that I'm just being a little weird. I can turn myself up a bit. Probably. Where? What? Yeah, so that's my Yeti. My Yeti's recording. Is that a little better? Should I turn it up more, less? Well, we'll try that for now. See if that helps. Would it be effecting or affecting? So I wanted 7 to be back outside. 8 could be the surprise attack. 9. Yeah, okay. I think we're good. Yeah, I forgot to adjust my lighting. It's fine. The natural light works really well right now. I'm not sure what the temperature is right now. Yesterday it was minus 21, which is minus 30 with the wind chill. Don't need this page. Yeah, that makes sense, because now I have a couple extra panels on this page that I can use to be like, yep. I know the feeling, Sam. I know the feeling. Okay, cool. Does that make sense? So this would be page 7. I was doing it right all along, guys. I'm not crazy. Sweet. This page to be 2 panels. So this to be my second panel. I got there. That works for me. And this one will be we're good. So I'll show you my sketches. So, I haven't completely figured out page 1 yet, but 2, 3, I want it to be a giant spread. So this is like the valley line, and you can see the house. And I didn't draw in Hyperonor, but I should. It'll be like little baby looking down the house. And then the bottom panels there will be him sneaking through the forest. And then this is him opening the gate, entering the house, the kitchen with all its horror. I haven't figured out 7 yet, but that'll be the searching. And then 8, 9 will be like punch, him rolling on the ground with the impact, and then the siren, kind of a single panel shot of kind of like him on the ground, like prone, like looking up at the siren in like big. I would argue that Hyperonor would not have a beard. Mostly because that wasn't a huge thing in Greek culture. Am I wrong about that, or am I thinking of something else? Maybe I'm thinking of Romans. Because I'm thinking of things like a lot of the frescoes and art on clay pots and that kind of stuff. And I don't remember there really being very many beards. A few here and there, but just not a ton of them. And I know that... that was the thing? What was the thing? That they don't have beards? Or that women and children don't have beards? I'm confused now. Huh. Yeah, I was just reading about that now. Because it was designed to emulate the gods. Excuse me. Cool. Alright, I'm wrong. It happens. Sure, because it was a sign of virility. We know how virile he was. I think it's possible that this panel should go on the previous page. Not that page, this page. Then I can do these two panels. What? Oh, no, sorry. I forgot to go back here. My bad. So basically what I did just there was I labeled my pages, I shifted the fight stuff around a bit so that I could get it to fit in what my idea of the panel should be. Push off, deflecting the fist, there's like back and forth there, then he's bleeding, blah, blah, things happen. I didn't even write beard one time, you are correct. How's this gonna... Yes, this will be page 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. My bad, guys. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I didn't write beard even one time. Yeah. I'm wondering if this should be its own page. I haven't even sent it in yet, Ronnie. Plus, you won't hear back for at least 3 months, probably. Either way, that's about the regular length of time. No, I finished the second last draft. It needs to be edited one more time before I send it in. I gave it to a bunch of people to read so that I could get feedback. 'Cause that's important. The other thing I want to look into, and if anyone here knows about it, too would, but I know there's a couple of good sites. I gotta find them again, but there's some places that are good for keeping track of your submissions so that you can get it all, keep track of your submissions and their status and all that kind of stuff, so that you don't have to, like, it's easy to be on top of things. And yes, it ended up being called dinner. gonna duplicate this actually. Call this 14 the fight 5 and 15 the fight 6. And this one will not be any of this. Yeah. Oh, Duotrope has a submissions tracker. Okay, perfect. That's exactly what I wanted to know. Cool. Useful. Alright. I'm gonna be taking a break in a few minutes. Yeah. So this doesn't happen on this page. Thank you.
Not really. It's just a way of thinking, and once you get used to it, it's not a big deal. Mostly, it comes down to you don't want to show too many actions in one panel, so any singular action should probably just be one panel, and then it's figuring out where you want panels and how you want it set up. Yeah. That would be extremely helpful, though. Keep in mind that what I'm putting here is not going to be the final text of the panel. It's just what is a placeholder for now while I figure out what the adaptation is going to look like. Perfect, because then the blow happens there, and we can just have music. Head, fist. Oh well. If I only have 2 pages left, let's finish this up. So I remember saying that I want this to be 16/17. At least those panels, though there might be one or two more.
think that's how I'm going to break that up. Page 18, page 19. Oh, you know what? No, I need to do one more page. I was originally thinking that page 19 would be like a chapter title, but I don't think that works if I'm not doing a chapter title for the first one. So like, because the encounter with the Siren is not like a prologue, right? So you, anyway, gist is I think 19 is just going to be this, and I will use the space to do a lot more with this idea that I have for the this kind of thing. For example, I actually think this panel might be better off on the 16-17 split. And then I can do a really neat thing with page 18 as a one-page spread. Well, it depends what you mean by writing, Johnny. I just finished the first section there, the first scene. In fact, if this first scene is 19 pages, I wouldn't have to do much to buff it up to like 23 or so, which would be perfect. Like 22, yeah. Well, I mean, yes and no. I'm not specifically going to necessarily go deep into, like, writing out each panel. But I think this is an important part of the writing process. Like, figuring all this stuff out. I'm thinking now that if I wanted, how many words is scene number two? So scene number one, stylus, where'd it go? Here's stylus. All right. don't know where my stylus went. Weird. So the first scene is 872 words. How much is the second scene? 557. 3 is 460. Actually, we should use 703. 557, 460. So, yeah. So, arguably speaking, these are, and I'm going to take a break right after I finish talking about this. These are the word counts for the five scenes that we have sort of planned so far. At 703, the first scene is the longest. Though we've spent more time on that one than some of the others, and the others can probably be fleshed out. What I'm saying here is I could potentially do it so each scene was an issue. Do it as a like 4 or 5 issue miniseries. Yeah, I love this thing. It's super useful. The interesting thing to note about that, and it's something I haven't talked about that much on the stream, but a little bit, is that the reason I don't work on a lot of my like personal projects on stream is because publishing rights get very complicated. That being said, as a comic book, and as a really strong comic book, actually a lot stronger than The Drafting Dungeon, in my opinion, in terms of a story, it'd be really cool if I could attach an artist to this project and I could get it published by an actual comic book publisher. That is an option here. We're not under the same limitations because it's a script as we are a piece of prose that you would want to sell to a magazine, for example. So yeah, that is a potential option here and is something I am considering right at this moment. I feel like this first scene is a strong first issue. I'd have to buff it up a few pages. It's a little short at the moment, but I think that's definitely doable. I mean, we have a lot of leeway with sort of the kitchen scene, for example. We could add a second page there, make that a 2-page spread, add a second page, make back outside page 9, for example, where it would have, you know, that's an extra 2 pages there, getting our total up to 21, which is a lot closer. Yeah, that might be an idea, Johnny. Fancy is awesome. For those who don't know, we're talking about Fancy Schmancy TV, a good friend of mine who streams on Twitch. He's an awesome comic book artist. You know him, Sam. He's that guy. Sorry, his real name is Steven Bovet. He does a lot of cool things. He's the guy whose webcomic I showed you about the 3-panel jokes about aliens that was really, really legit a few months ago. Anyway, check out his stuff. We got a shout out command, right? Yeah, there you go. Thanks, Johnny. Go check out his work. He recently did a very cool portrait of me, actually, on his stream, which I can show you here. Toss it up. He did this for me. And that's by Derek, but there you go. He's got a really cool style. So, yeah.
it's something to consider. I don't know 100% what I want to do with this yet, but I love Fancy. Fancy's awesome. Right. So, I'm going to take a 10-minute break, and I'll come back at 2 o'clock, and we'll work on this for another 45 minutes or so, at least. I'm going to see if I can get this up to a full, like, 22 pages sort of thing. Probably 23 would be better. So about 23. That was a funny picture I sent him ages ago. At the time when I took the picture, I had that much beard. It happens. But yeah. So yeah, 10-minute break. I'll see you all back here. And we'll keep going.